everybody, it's Asbel, and I'm in Selma, Alabama at Old Live Oak Cemetery. And behind me, well, this is the tomb of William Rufus King, Alabama's only U.S. Vice President and our nation's first gay Vice President. Gay Vice President? Do what? It's true. Let me tell you about him. King was born in North Carolina to a wealthy family and moved to Alabama around the time it became a state in 1819. He built the largest plantation in Alabama, and at its height, he owned 500 slaves who worked his farm. Now, King was Alabama's first U.S. Senator, and he would serve 5 terms in Washington. Now, while in Washington, he shared a boarding house room with James Buchanan. Buchanan would later become our only U.S. president who never married. He was engaged as a young man, but just before his wedding, he had a talk with his fiancée, took her aside, and immediately after that talk, she committed suicide. It was a big scandal. Now, the relationship that King and Buchanan had was the talk of Washington. President Andrew Jackson openly referred to them as Aunt Fancy and Miss Nancy. And when both men died, their families destroyed all of the correspondence between them. Now, one letter that Buchanan wrote a friend has survived, and it reads, "I am now solitary and alone, having no companion in the house with me," because King was in France serving as the United States Minister to France. "I have gone a wooing to several gentlemen, but have not succeeded with any of them. I feel that it is not good for a man to be alone, and I should not be astonished to find myself with some old maid who can nurse me when I am sick, provide good dinners for me when I am well, and not expect from me any very ardent or romantic affection." Now, in 1852, King was chosen to run as vice president on the Democratic ticket with Franklin Pierce, and they won. But during the election, King had come down with tuberculosis, and he went to Cuba to try to recover. By the time the inauguration came around, his condition was worse, not better. So Congress passed a law allowing him to be sworn in as vice president on foreign soil, the only vice president to do so. King got worse and worse and worse, and finally he told his servants, "Take me back to Alabama." He went on the very arduous trek, and 2 days after he arrived back here in Selma, King died. He is the only vice president sworn in on foreign soil, and he only served 6 weeks as vice president, and not a day of it in Washington, D.C. That, my friends, is the story of Alabama's vice president and our only gay vice president, William Rufus King.